Life in our modern age can be rather hectic, and sometimes you have no choice but to grab a meal on the go. Other times, all you want to do is shove food down your face hole as fast as possible so you can move on. Even our entertainment demands that we eat fast, like to that next match of Fortnite because your team is waiting on you and they're getting pretty sick of you being AFK. As problems with digestive health and obesity become more prevalent, it's clear that our fast-paced food consumption is creating serious problems for us, problems that might just be fixed by us eating slower. In general obesity rankings, Spain sits at number 62, with 23.8% of the population being obese, versus the United States, where it's 36.2% of the population. While there are a variety of factors to explain this difference, it appears to be that Spain's eating culture is a leading cause for this disparity between the two modern and industrialized nations. In Spain, the typical meal can take at least an hour, and is seen as a social affair to be enjoyed with coworkers and family. Yes, even midday lunches can run for a full hour, if not more. Family dinners tend to be late in the day and can last as long as 2 hours, especially when they involve large gatherings of family members or friends, as they often do. Spain's social eating culture drags out the process of eating in comparison with the United States, where the average meal is scarfed down as quickly as possible. In 2011, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, a group of 34 mostly Western countries, did a study on the eating habits of their member states and the domestic lives of their populations. The study found that Americans spend far less time eating than any other nation, with just 1 hour and 14 minutes a day dedicated to the task of shoveling food into their mouths, versus the average of 1 hour and 41 minutes for the rest. But how big of a deal is it that other nations eat far slower than us, and just why should we learn to pace ourselves with our food? Does it really matter? Well, as it turns out, yes, and the benefits are many. The main reason for eating slowly has to do with our body's basic biological functions. Your brain is an incredible organ capable of lightning-fast calculations, yet strangely, we evolved so that a signal from your stomach to your brain saying, "Hey, I'm pretty full up on food here," takes on average a whopping 20 minutes. That's a grand distance of about 2.5 feet for most people, and that's a pretty infuriating thought for people struggling with weight gain when you consider that neurons transmit signals at a speed of 0.5 milliseconds. For the record, it takes you between 300 and 400 milliseconds to blink an eye. Your brain is basically the flash, sending and receiving signals from every part of your body at blazing speeds. But when it comes to the double cheeseburger with extra order of fries you just scarfed down because you felt like you were starving, your brain turns into a sloth on a bicycle with a flat tire. But if you eat slow enough that your tortoise brain has a chance to recognize it, you'll soon feel like you're no longer starving and will probably stop throwing those fistfuls of French fries fried in pure trans fats down your gullet. Feeling full will prevent you from overeating, which directly leads to slowing down or halting weight gain from unnecessary calories. Yet as annoying as this little brain hack is in our modern lives, it's in fact a lifesaver from back in the days before civilization and the all-important fast food restaurant were on every corner. Before civilization and all its modern and delicious fast food conveniences, we didn't always know where our next meal was coming from. Therefore, stuffing ourselves to the point of literal bursting became an evolutionary prerogative, because back then it was good to be fat, as fat could be burned during the times when food was scarce, which was something like 99% of the time because it really sucked to be alive back then. Thus, it's likely we evolved with such a slow stomach trigger that we were able to overeat and ensure that we would pack away precious pounds of fat for when food resources became scarce. What likely saved the lives of your ancestors is now helping add unnecessary and unwanted pounds to your waistline. Because even though technology has made us masters of most of our world, nature still has its ways of letting you know that it hates you deeply. Eating slowly can do more than just benefit your health, though. It also helps with food satisfaction. When we researched for this episode, we found a lot of feel-good, new-agey mumbo-jumbo about food satisfaction, making your soul feel good, or connecting you to your food and thus enhancing nutrition. That's not how science works, so we mostly disregarded it all. But it turns out there's one really good reason to worry about food satisfaction. That has to do with laboratory-developed processed foods, which are made to taste especially good when eaten quickly, because when eaten slowly, you start to notice that the flavors really just don't hold up. This makes sense when you think about it. Certain processed foods are a hodgepodge of dozens of different elements all trying to blend together to create nice flavors. And the slower you eat them, the more of that careful blend falls apart in your mouth and starts to taste like… Well, like a hodgepodge of dozens of different elements. Many natural foods, though, like fruits, maintain their flavor for far longer, even when you eat slowly. This might not seem like a big deal until you start to think about the fact that if you develop a habit to eat slower, you're naturally going to start avoiding foods that taste terrible when eaten slowly, and which happen to also be the same ones that are terrible for your health. Eating slower will prompt you towards more natural, healthier foods and away from highly processed things like flavored potato chips or candy bars and all the sugar, fat, and calories that come along with them. We hear you though. We were skeptical too, which is why we have a mini challenge for you. Next time you're at a gas station, go ahead and buy yourself a pack of those wrapped up chocolate donuts, the small ones, then pop one in your mouth and go ahead and chew it for about 10 seconds and tell us how you feel. Unless you have the taste buds of a goat, you're going to start feeling pretty gross after about the fifth second. So you now see why many snacks like this are purposefully small. They trick you into eating more and thus buying more, but also into eating them quickly. You can even try it with a Twinkie, which even we admit at first glance seems to be one of mankind's finest creations. But pop one of those into your mouth for a good 10 seconds and see how you feel about yourself afterwards. So just eat slower and you'll naturally want to eat healthier foods. It makes a lot of basic sense. Eating slowly also has a direct benefit on your digestion. Now we realize that most of our audience is younger and the idea of improving your digestion is laughable and a 100% non-concern. Oh boy, we literally can't wait for you to get into your 30s. We have such terrible, horrible wonders to show you. You might have a bulletproof gut right now, but believe us, that's not gonna last. You're getting older every day, the grains of life slowly but inexorably slipping through your fingers and ushering you ever forward to your inevitable death and bad digestion. So you should really start building good habits now, or you'll spend a significant amount of your limited time on this earth squatting over the toilet. When you sit down for a meal, your body starts going into digestion mode almost immediately. First, your mouth starts salivating so that enzymes in your saliva can break down food and moisten it, which makes it easier to slide that barbecue bacon cheeseburger down your throat. Our stomach gets the signal that food is incoming and starts to secrete more stomach acids to help further break down food and push it through into the intestines. For its part, the small intestine starts prepping itself for peristalsis, or the muscle contractions that help push food along. When you sit down and rush a meal, you're basically throwing food into a digestive system that isn't quite ready to deal with it yet. Fast, large bites means that food is inadequately chewed, which is already a pretty big deal because it makes it more difficult for that food to be turned into chyme, the liquid mix of digested food, hydrochloric acid, digestive enzymes, and water. When your stomach doesn't have time to properly digest food, it can lead to constipation, acid reflux, and spontaneous combustion from the buildup of gases. We made one of those up, but we're not telling you which, because we care about you and we want you to be healthier, even if it's through sheer terror. If you're still skeptical about the benefits of eating slowly, consider a University of Rhode Island study where researchers served lunch on two different occasions to 30 normal weight women. The meal in both cases was a huge plate of pasta with sauce and Parmesan cheese, along with a glass of water. At each meal, the researchers asked the women to eat to the point of comfortable fullness, but on the first visit they were told to eat as quickly as possible, while on the second they were asked to eat slowly and put down their utensils between bites. The difference between eating fast and slowly came out to 646 calories in 9 minutes versus 579 calories in 29 minutes, or 67 calories. Spread that across 3 meals and that adds up to a significant amount of extra calories per day, making you gain weight. Also, the women who ate quickly reported feeling hungrier an hour later than those who ate slowly. So not only are you consuming more calories, but you're creating a greater temptation to add extra calories from snacks and junk food. So how can you change your current eating habits and start to eat slower and healthier? As usual, we've got your back. Number 1. Be social. Making your meal a social experience can help extend the amount of time it takes to actually eat that meal. Friendly conversation helps keep food out of your mouth, provided you don't talk while you chew, which we could do an entire other video about. Number 2. Change your eating environment. Instead of scarfing down pizza in front of your computer, sit down at the dining room table like a real human being. Something as simple as changing your environment can make you feel more mindful of the food you're eating and help you eat slower. Number 3. Count your chews. As you chew, count the number of times your mouth goes up and down, which we admit sounds super annoying, but research shows it can help lose weight by increasing the calories the body burns during digestion. Number 4. Drink water between bites. Not only does it physically slow you down, but it helps you feel fuller faster, which will limit the amount of food you ultimately eat. Number 5. Move to North Korea. Eating food in North Korea is illegal, so you won't even have to worry about eating slower. Now that you've learned all about how eating slower can be a huge health benefit, do you think you'll be more mindful about the way you eat? Also, make sure you check out our other video, This Is Why You're Fat! And as always, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more great content.